Hi everyone, Miroslav here. Today I want to talk about one common problem we all face when using art generators. I'm talking about the fact that all the images are small, and when you want to sell such artwork as prints or on any print-on-demand marketplace in general, you need to make the image bigger. But upscaling images from 512 pixels or 1024 pixels to the dimension most POD marketplaces prefer is complicated. While you can upsize your image 2 times almost without losing quality, upscaling to 5000 by 5000 or even to 8000 by 8000, which is a dimension I prefer for Redbubble or Zazzle, is difficult. While there are many free AI-powered upscalers you can find online, most of them are horrible and cannot be used for prints. And the paid ones are overpriced, at least in the comparison with the tool I'm using. So, in this video, I want to show you my favorite AI-powered upscaling software that I'm using to upscale the AI-generated art. As you probably know, the issue with the free online upscaling tools is that you can upsize your image only 2 times or 4 times, and the resulting images are not good enough for POD. That's why you need to stick with paid tools. And the internet is full of good tools, like IMG Upscaler, AI Image Enlarger, or Gigapixel, but they are pretty expensive when you compare the functionality with the price. This is the reason why I'm using Photoshop to upscale all the artwork I'm generating with Stable Diffusion text-to-image model. I understand it's expensive software, but it's definitely worth every penny. And converting low-resolution images to high-resolution in Photoshop is surprisingly easy. It also uses AI to do the work. So, let's go to Photoshop. And the first thing you need to do is make sure that you have one crucial feature enabled. So go to the Edit, find the Preferences, and then click on General. In this window, you need to find Technology Previews and make sure you have enabled the Preserve Details 2.0 feature. If this feature is enabled, let's go back to the photo I have made with Dream Studio AI. And because I'm using the default 512 by 512 pixel size, when generating art with the art generator, I get really small resulting photos. When you click on the image and select the image size option, you can see what I'm talking about. I get a small photo with only 72 dpi resolution, which cannot be used on any print-on-demand marketplace. Luckily, this image size window is all I need to upscale my AI artwork. Firstly, make sure the dimension is in pixels and then increase the resolution to 300 dpi. This is a standard dot per pixel density for prints. While you can use higher dpi, I like to use 300 as a main value. Next, upsize the image by changing the width and height values. Because I want to sell this photo as wall art, I'm using the 6000 by 8000 dimension size. When all this is done, you need to make sure the resemble option is checked and the preserve details 2.0 option is selected. To show you the power of AI in Photoshop, let's zoom out to find some place with more details. For this example, I'm just using the eye to explain the difference. If I go back to the original DPI of 72, you can see how pixelated the eye on the image is. Now, when I go back to 300 DPI, take a look at how clear and smooth it is. But this is not all. To play more with the image, you have to use the reduce noise slider and find the sweet spot. When you use the minimal percentage, you can see that the image is sharper, but when you use the maximum value, it looks almost unnatural. This is why you need to find an ideal value. About 50 or 60% is ideal for most of my designs. I think when you use this value, you can still get a sharp image with a decently smooth look. To show you how the image has improved, let's compare the original image with the new one. I have both images here in Photoshop, and right now you are looking at the original image. You can see how it's pixelated, and when I use the new image to compare it with, you can definitely see the difference. So, what we did with the image is that we took all the pixelated places and then made the image larger with a higher resolution so the pixels are less noticeable. I understand that not everyone can afford to pay for Photoshop, but for me it is an incredibly useful tool worth the money. This tool can easily upscale the image to my preferred dimensions and make it look better. I hope you have learned something new in this video, and if you have any question, then use the comment section and I will try to reply.